Good afternoon, friends. Myself Sainath Lambade, and we are going to continue the beat of the chapter control and coordination. In that, we are going to discuss about the part of hindbrain, that is medulla oblongata. Now we are going to discuss about the medulla oblongata. In last lecture, we have discussed about the cerebellum. Cerebellum is the second largest brain of the human body. As now we are going to discuss, this is the last part, and this last part of the brain that is going to be continuous in the in spinal cord. This medulla oblongata, now we are going to discuss. This medulla oblongata is the posterior conical, that is like a cone-like structure, conical part of the brain, and continues as a spinal cord. This medulla oblongata is the posterior region of the human brain, and that is going to continue as a spinal cord. It has inner gray matter. Now you have to keep in mind that we have discussed in the cerebrum, then cerebellum, that outer was the gray matter and inner was white matter. But here is a different, that it has inner gray matter and outer there is having the presence of white matter. It controls involuntary vital functions. Like, now we'll see that this is a part of cerebrum. This is a diencephalon, this is a midbrain, this is a pons veroli, this is a cerebellum, and followed by that we are going to discuss the now last region, that is the posterior region of the human brain. This is a medulla oblongata, and many involuntary centers lies in the medulla oblongata. See there, respiratory rhyme center means related with the respiration, as we have seen. Then followed to that, there is also having another center, that is a cardiovascular center, also lies in the medulla oblongata. Another center, coughing center, you are getting a cough, then you give a yawning, that is also yawning center, lies in the medulla oblongata. Then swallowing, whatever you are eating, that is going to be swallowed inside, that is also center, lies in the medulla oblongata. And vomiting center, that is also lies in a medulla oblongata. The cavity of medulla is called as a fourth ventricle. The cavity is also present in the medulla, and that cavity is called as a fourth ventricle or metacele. That is called as a metacele. As we have seen in the last lecture, the third ventricle that is actually present in the, this third ventricle actually present in the, this diencephalon. And these are the two ventricles present in the, this is a part of cerebrum, and these two ventricles are called as a lateral ventricles. Ventricles means cavity. First two cavity are present in the cerebrum, followed by third cavity that is present in the diencephalon, and now fourth cavity is present in the medulla. So anybody ask you the question, how many cavities are present in the brain? First two are the lateral ventricles, cerebrum, then these are the first and second cavity, and this is a third cavity, that is known as a diencephale. And this is a medulla mein fourth cavity, that is called as a metacele. So in human brain, there is having the four cavity. First two cavity in the cerebrum, third cavity in the diencephalon, and fourth cavity in the medulla, that is called as a metacele. Third that is present in the diencephalon, that is called a diencephale, and these two are called as a lateral ventricles. These are called as a lateral ventricles. So four cavities are mainly present in the human brain. So that roof of the medulla oblongata has the posterior choroid plexus. The roof of the medulla oblongata is having posteriorly presence of choroid plexus cells, and this choroid plexus, as you know, that help in the secretion of what? That helps in the secretion of CSF fluid. CSF means cerebrospinal fluid. Posterior choroid plexus have three opening. Posterior choroid plexus have three opening. That is lateral opening. This lateral are the two openings that is called as a foramen of Luschka. That is called as a foramen. Foramen means opening. Foramen of Luschka and median opening that is called as a foramen of Magden. Foramen of Magden. That is called as a foramen of Magden. And now we'll see the last point about the medulla oblongata. As you know that medulla oblongata, in medulla, that point now we are going to discuss about the medulla oblongata, that is a decussation of pyramid. Decussation of pyramid. In the medulla oblongata, 90% of axons in the left pyramid cross the right side, and 90% axons of from the right pyramid crosses the left side. As all of you know that right side of our body controls the left side and left side of our body controls the right side. So similarly, that is shown, the crossing of these axons take place in the this medulla, that is called as a decussation of pyramid. This little bit part which is coming upward region, that is showing upward region, that is called as a pyramid, that is known as a pyramid, this part of the medulla. As you seeing this, these axons are coming from right side, and at this point they are turning here, and another left side axon is coming, that left is going to the right. Right side came and that has been moved to the left, and left came and moved to the right side. So this part, this part is called as a decussation part. This is called as a decussation, means crossing of the axons. Crossing of the axon, right axon will go to the left and left will go to the right side. So right side of our this body controls the left side, and left side will control the right side. And last point, sudden damage to the medulla oblongata can cause a death because it controls most of the involuntary centers. It controls the involuntary centers like breathing, you know that, then cardiovascular center. So thank you for this lecture. Have a good day.